Vikings goal by number 35. Christina Hindle, her second of the game. That brings us to the end of the first quarter, with the Vikings leading 5-0. We wish good luck to the St. John's Catholic Prep softball team as they begin their IAAMB conference play with a road game at Roland Park School today. The softball team is 2-1 and riding a two-game win streak as they enter the heart of the conference schedule.
Oh, is it the same one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Looks different from...
She's good.
She's my daughter.
Oh, congratulations, Obama. I'm fond of her, too.
Long drive. So we don't have long drive to
yeah, we're actually moving here too.
Oh, are you?
Oh, okay. Yeah, we don't
nice.
Have any public products in Minneapolis, so.
There you go. Yeah, I believe it.
Why not? It's actually smart idea.
It's a beautiful area.
It
down
is. There. It's really beautiful.
Yes. Thank you. tackle. Okay, I'll do that. All right.
Vikings goal by number 11, Mason Walker.
That should be goal.
Should be goal.
No goal.
It was always interesting to see what they call.
New rules, same time.
Same time? That's why I said it'd be interesting to see what they call.
Like, we want a free shot.
It's dangerous because if a girl shoots it, you could hit the girl in the chest or the face or something. It typically happens when two that are on the low side right now, when a girl from the top drives and a girl from the low comes up at you, that's where you see the performance. So like if you drive, they're gonna, the girl that's not guarding her will slide in front of you.
Good job, Taylor Lewis! Eagles goal by number 15, Jessica Shepherd. Vikings goal by Addison Scanlon, her second of the contest. Vikings goal by number 35, Christina Hindle, with an assist to number 25, Maya Graham. Vikings lead 8-1.
Mercy just had that one class of girls that was really good.
They are.
No go. Officials say the Viking was in the crease.
Keep it up, Ryan. Riley, yes!
Assist to Maya Graham. The Vikings lead 9-1.
Thank you.
That's the end of the first half. The Vikings winning 9-1.
Trying to Jeremiah say what are Reagan's tops?
Shout out to the St. John's Catholic Prep Boys Lacrosse team, who are all unbeaten this season after two straight appearances in the MIAAC Conference Championship. The Vikings are hoping to return to the championship game for a third time and to win their second championship in 3 years. The Vikings will host Crystal Lake Jesuit School here at Warner Field at St. John's on Thursday, April 18th at 4:30. Before that, the boys will play a road game at Annapolis Area Christian on Tuesday.
Went to all their prospects.
Yeah, we saw Sutra and Carlos at Syracuse. We were up there at the same time. He had just been at Northwestern and Boston College.
Also tomorrow, the boys' baseball team will be in action at historic McCurdy Stadium, downtown Frederick, as they will host the Glenelg Country Day School Dragons at 4.
Yeah, they did that.
The Vikings baseball team is 3-4 overall this season, with an MIAA B Conference Black Division record of 2-3.
No, in that 26 class too, they one kid, I guess, when it was in the yeah, they kind of kicked her to the curb. They got the parents.
Because I've heard mixed stories. Like, some people think that they're like awesome and great, and some people can't stand them.
Yeah, I don't know them personally, so I can only tell you what I viewed as an outsider looking in, you know? And I've seen it both ways, because I observed them, but they down to the point.
Exactly.
Yeah. and then it imploded from there.
That's probably the best way.
I think that's a great way of putting it.
Yeah,
right. Yeah, that's brilliant.
Everybody's got different stories.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the truth is somewhere in the middle.
That's exactly what it is. Always a great one.
Yeah. It's a good player.
Yeah.
Thing called a callback. give the ball to the goalie.
It's onions and peppers. It's a hard no. Onions
well,
and
it should have been
on
the goal.
Don't tell me you
it would
know.
Be fair to you.
Oh. People say, my dad used to tell me growing up, you'd put that Lipton soup mix in
it may be too far.
And he's like, you can't even taste it. I'm like, I can literally see the onions. It tastes like an onion burger.
It should have been a goal.
Because of shot clock.
Shot clock ran, and then the goal went in.
They don't stop the shot clock in the third or fourth quarter.
So the fair call would have been, just give it to the goalie.
Good job, Christina.
Instead of doing the job. Their powwow was probably to be mindful of it next time.
Although we were playing IMG Florida like last week or whatever.
That was that rough game.
It was rough. But what happened was in the first quarter, IMG had a free possession.
Uh-huh.
And our coach kept moving our defenders.
Oh, did they call him? Go!
No, just kept moving hash to hash and a cock right now. It was. So they tried to do it to us in the third quarter, and our coach called a timeout.
That's awesome.
10 seconds left. So we got our free position. They didn't get there.
Oh, that's hysterical.
They won by one goal. So
who's your coach, Reese?
Reese.
Yeah. That's so funny. That was brilliant.
Muffins.
Oh, that was funny. They call it Spoon.
I know. I heard about this. How's that even possible?
It's like she's the cool. She was like, she was out of
access. It wasn't even. Well, the girl from Concordia was doing this the whole way down the field. And then they called it on us.
Running. by number 21, Kaylee Storm.
Nice, Addie. Yes. Oh, so good. Oh, no, Ryan. She was so
good. Knocked out. She didn't. The referee didn't get down. So he never did that.
No. Oh, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Good job, Ryan. Nice goal, Maya.
Vikings goal by number 25, Maya Graham. With an assist to Ryan Piccolo. Number 36, Addison Scanlon.
Sure, that's that, hey, you know, all-star. was right here. Chest line. Love the shoulder.
That is the end of the third quarter. The Vikings are leading 13-1.
Just for the IAM.
Yes.
So, okay. So, we're picking the game.
Yeah, and we almost have the same reps in every game. For Farley's games.
So,
yeah.
Like A can rep B and C.
Yeah.
Just B can rep C and B.
Yeah.
But C can only just do C.
Yes. They would not have to be able to. For this game, it's terrible for what the other teams like abilities. Like, if you allow the play, really,
I was like, I was like, don't draw my blood, like, what do I do?
Thank you. Gave a yellow card for that. I know.
Thank you.
establish yourself.
Saved by Holland Swoop. Number 21, Kaylee Storm, with an assist to Maya Graham. Vikings lead 14-1.
We're just going to
That's the final. Final score, Vikings 14, Eagles 1. Thank you for coming out to watch the Vikings this evening. The girls lacrosse team is back in action on Wednesday for a huge home game. And it is a rematch of last year's IAAMB championship as the Bruins from the Park School will come to Waterfield. Last time these two teams played, the 19-2 road victory. That game will be scheduled for Wednesday at 4:30 here at St. John's Catholic Prep. Please go home and have a great day.
Wait, where's... Oh, you get that. Yeah. How are you doing? Right, I know you're a lot, so I feel good about it.